See, this is lymph, and lymph is one of the important circulatory system. And here you see, when blood is flowing through the blood vessels, and the blood vessels is divided into arteries, arterioles, capillaries. And this is arteriole, and arteriole is divided into capillary. Near the capillary, the blood is coming out. Because when blood is flowing through the blood vessels, it is flowing with high hydrostatic pressure. And the walls of the blood vessels is actually thick. They have the three layers, tunica external, tunica medium, tunica internal. But near the capillaries, it is having only one layer, that is endothelium. Because it is the layer very thin, the blood is coming out. The blood which is comes out of the blood vessel is named as ECF, extracellular fluid, or it is known as tissue fluid. And this fluid is bringing all the nutrients, oxygen, everything into the near to the tissues. And the ECF, which is rich in oxygen and nutrients, is used by tissues. In return, tissues is producing the CO2 and nitrogenous waste. So this CO2 waste which is present in these tissues is going back into the blood vessels near the venular end of capillaries. It is came out at arterial end of capillary. It is going back at venular end of capillaries. And it is comes out because of hydrostatic pressure, but it is going back because of the osmotic pressure. See, it is when the blood is coming out, the blood is having the plasma proteins, RBC, WBC, larger in the size. That is why that is unable to come. Only liquid portion is came out. And when in the liquids, the dissolved components is came out, but the plasma proteins is relatively looks large, that is present inside, like albumin. Albumin is responsible for osmotic pressure. So because albumin is more, here the plasma proteins are more, so osmotic pressure is more. And here the low osmotic pressure, more osmotic pressure, the fluids is going from low to high. And that is when the fluid is going back, nearly 85% of the fluid which is came out, in that 85% is went back. But still some 15% fluid is left over, and that left over 15% fluid is called as the lymph. That is ECF. This is also ECF. Initially which the fluid came out is ECF, and that is going back, and leftover remaining 15% ECF is going back into the lymph capillaries. This ECF is now has actually more CO2 and more wastes. Initially when the ECF is came out, it is having more O2, more nutrients, but now more CO2, more waste. It is going into lymph capillaries. Lymph capillaries, the fluid ECF which is entered into lymph capillaries is now named as lymph. Then lymph capillaries united to form lymph vessels united to form lymph ducts, and all the lymph ducts is became a large lymph ducts near the thorax region, one on the left side, one on the right side, right thoracic duct, left thoracic duct. This thoracic duct is carrying the lymph, which is releasing this lymph into the blood capillaries, the large blood vessels called as subclavian vein and jugular vein. Into these veins, the lymphatic duct is releasing the lymph. So that is about the lymph. And you may get doubt here, why this fluid is separated from the blood vessels and why again going back. And in this method also it is gone back to the blood. So why it is coming out? When it is coming out, it is bringing oxygen and nutrients, and it is given to tissues. And when it is going back, it is taking CO2 and waste from tissues and giving to blood. That means in between the blood and the tissues, this lymph ECF is working like a middleman. So that is the use of the ECF. So this is about the body fluids, blood and lymph. And if you see the blood groups, so we'll see the blood groups. Blood groups. Man has the blood groups A, B, O and AB. So in this blood group is mainly decided by the antigen presenting on the RBC. And if you see the blood is having the plasma and pumped elements. plasma has antibodies and RBCs is having antigens. But the surface antigen which is present on the RBC is deciding the blood group of a person. So if you take the blood groups like there is a gene called as I gene, and I gene is having the alleles. Generally one gene has two alleles, but the blood group I gene is having the three alleles, that is IA and IB and IO. So in these alleles, A allele and B allele both are dominant and IO is recessive. So if you see IA is equal to IB, and these two are greater than IO. And here we can learn one thing called as codominance. That is IA and IB, whenever these two is present, IA and IB. As per law of dominance, in heterozygous state only one expressed. But here the A and B, both the different alleles, both are expressing and giving the blood group called as AB blood group. So it is example, blood group is example of codominance. And you can say this is the IA and IB, both are equally dominant, and but this two is dominant over IO. So that is why whenever you find a combination of IA IO, because A is dominant, here we will get A. And if you get a combination IB IO and B is dominant, so B. And to get O group, that is only option IO IO, then only we will get a O group. So this is a different types of phenotypes for the blood groups: AB blood group, A blood group, B blood group, O blood group. So there is four phenotypes present with blood groups. But what is the different types of genotypes for blood groups? See, AB blood group is having only one genotype, IAIB. But A blood group is having option, is a heterozygous A group, and there is a homozygous A group also there. And B blood group, IBIO, heterozygous, IBIB is homozygous. And this is also having the only one. To get O group, only one option, homozygous IOIO. So how many genotypes we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 genotypes is there with blood groups, but phenotypes are 4. That is AB, A group, B group, O group. This is the 4 types of blood groups. And mainly the blood group is decided by the presence and absence of the antigens. So what are the antigens? What are the antibodies present in the blood groups? We'll see. Channel.